Aortic stenosis is actually the most common valvular heart disease that we see in the elderly population. The aortic valve sits in between the main pumping chamber of the heart and the aorta, the main artery that delivers blood throughout the body. As that valve becomes narrowed and can't open as far, less blood can come out of the heart, less blood to feed the organs, and symptoms tend to develop. Shortness of breath, fatigue, exertional chest discomfort, congestive heart failure are all manifestations of severe aortic stenosis as that valve narrows down.
It's impressive how many people are willing to accept those symptoms. And our aim is to, one, tell them that we can help to prevent deterioration of the heart muscle function, and to give them, one, better survival, a better quality of life.
At Reading Hospital, one of the most important things we develop very early on is a very effective heart valve team. A heart valve team consists of interventional cardiologists like myself, cardiac surgeons, as well as our heart valve coordinator and the support team.
It allows for a team approach to the patient. They're seeing the cardiologist and the cardiac surgeon at the same time, and we discuss the patient, their issues, their concerns, our concerns, and we're able to give them the best treatment. We can do surgical valve replacement, or we can do what we call TAVR, or transaortic valve replacement.
And that's a way to replace the heart valve without having to do surgery. We can place that heart valve through an incision in the leg artery. We can then thread a little wire through that opening, put a valve over that wire, deliver that valve inside the old narrowed valve, and put a whole new one in its place. So we no longer use general anesthesia. It's done with conscious sedation. The whole procedure nowadays takes about 40 minutes or so, and most people go home within 1 or 2 days. So TAVR was a fascinating approach to managing aortic stenosis because it initially opened up a treatment avenue for a whole group of patients that had no options. Helping this usually older, sicker group of people who couldn't get through an operation get their valve fixed.
However, studies have shown that really the TAVR valve has become as good as the surgical valve replacement. And so we now are able to do that in people who we call at moderate risk.
For those of us that take care of these patients, it opened up a whole new group that we can offer this procedure to, knowing with good clinical trial data behind us and good outcomes that they're going to get a great result from a transcatheter approach. The valves, as soon as we implant it, start working instantly. Patients that day are up and walking around, and most of them have a pretty significant improvement in their symptoms and functional activity level as soon as the day of the procedure.
We're able to get them back to doing everything that they want to very rapidly, and also to have relief of whatever symptoms they may have presented with to us to improve their quality of life.
The Reading Hospital Heart Valve team has been working together as a group since around 2011. We've been implanting valves since 2012. And have had an excellent track record. Our outcomes are consistently better than national standards in regards to complication rates. Our hospital's lengths of stay are significantly shorter, and the overall experience of the patient is just amazing.